The 2012 Summer Olympics, just over a month away.
A Central Florida Olympian is looking to make history in London this summer. Hunter Kemper of Longwood is competing in his fourth Olympics in triathlon and hoping to become the first American man to medal in that sport.
West 2's Aix Diaz caught up with Kemper, who wasn't expecting another go at the Games.
If you had told Hunter Kemper just a few months ago he'd make the Olympic team again this year, he may not have believed you.
This past spring has been really a dark place for me and a hard place, and so I definitely had a lot of doubts.
First, Kemper broke his left elbow in a bicycle accident in October. Then, at the beginning of this year, he was out for 8 weeks with a staph infection. But on May 12th, he finished fifth in the San Diego Triathlon, securing a spot on Team USA.
It's been a great ride, and I'm happy going back to my fourth Games. It's kind of a small club for triathlon. I think it's just me and one other guy.
Kemper has yet to stand on the podium with a medal around his neck. He says unlike other Olympic sports that compete for days at a time, with triathlon, you only get one chance.
It's a one-day shot for us. It's hour and 50 minutes of racing, intense racing, and you know, you hope that with the jet lag, with all the travel and things, that your body comes up and turns up the way you want it to, like it has in training.
Kemper says the course in London will be thrilling for the athletes and spectators. Triathletes will be swimming, biking, and running through the heart of the city.
It's right there in Hyde Park in Central Park. So we'll start there and swim in the Serpentine Lake right there. We'll bike right by Buckingham Palace. And it's going to be all downtown streets, very city feel. We're like multiple loops on the bike, like 6 loops on the bike, 4 loops on the run.
Kemper says one of the highlights of every Olympics, his parents always travel to see him. They've been to Sydney, Athens, Beijing, and they'll be in London this summer. Aixa Diaz, West 2 News.